Council members' reports. Mayor Pro Tem Brown.
Thank you, Mayor, members of the council. I've only got a couple of things. I had the opportunity to attend the active shooting training at the Reidsville Police Department. Very informative. I'm glad we had that. I also attended a special meeting with our new superintendent of Rockingham County Schools, Mr. Sean Stover, over at the penthouse, and that was a very pleasant event, very informative. Attended the active shooter drill here at City Hall. That opened my eyes. I tell you, it got my blood pressure up, to be honest with you. And I attended the National Night Out event at Baptist Temple Church on August the 2nd. And on August the 5th, I attended the ribbon cutting ceremonies for Annie Penn Hospital's new chapel. And that did it for me.
Councilmember Desjardins.
Well, mine was very brief meetings this month. So on the 18th, I attended this special briefing at City Hall with the mayor. Then I also attended the Dangerous Crossroads training, which was very informative. I attended the RDC community business meeting and the active shooter training, which led me to look at training for the people, the employees that I have, and also where I live. And I also attended a special city meeting with the mayor on the 8th, the 1st of August. And I'd like to say that I think that where we're going to have the park, the water park is going to be very nice. It's going to be very special.
Diane, since Councilwoman Desjardins is the chamber liaison, give your report.
Absolutely. I feel like it's been a couple months. Thank you all for allowing Star to come in my place and give a report for the chamber. I appreciate you welcoming her. It is that time of year. We are super, super busy. We have several upcoming ribbon cuttings. The Boardwalk Baker will be this Thursday at the chamber, which is the 11th at noon. Thank you, Angela, for helping us coordinate all of that so we can pull their food truck up and the trailer up beside the chamber. Also, I think you all be really excited and definitely mark your calendars for the Reidsville Showcase Theater. We're finally going to be able to pull that together and do a ribbon cutting. And that is going to be, it's kind of an odd time, but we're going to do it at 2:00 right before they're getting ready for their show that night. So that's kind of when they're opening back up. You know, they don't do shows during the summer. So that's on the 9th of September. Kim Dow Permanent Makeup, really excited to have Miss Kim. I know a lot of folks use her to get their nails done, and my nail tech's been in the business for Reidsville for a long time, and now she's opened this permanent makeup business in that same, just next door in that strip. So that's on September 13th at 9 a.m. We also have multiple that are scheduled later September are in the works. We are at an all-time high of chamber membership, even through COVID. Most of our membership stayed, I think, just because of our partnerships and working through all the things. But we're at 428 members and still several in the pipe. And we're keeping Denise. Denise's part-time job is kind of a full-time job here lately. So also, just as far as upcoming events, the cruise-ins continue. We'll have the second Downtown Friday cruise-in, and that is working. That's actually working really well for what we are doing at Market Square. And I think there have been some concerns, and I'm sure some of you may have heard some of those. And I have just impressed upon Robin and Summer that we would continue to work together and figure out, because we had safety concerns long before the streetscape project and before we moved to Market Square. And from our standpoint of the beer garden, we have to make sure, right, that the traffic And so we've talked with the police department about this, and I think that there will be continued discussions going into next season what that looks like. And the city staff has just done an amazing job of keeping things organized and flowing within those constraints of Market Square, but also in looking out for the families that are coming out and the folks that are coming out and looking at the cars. So the golf for Reidsville, we are really excited. We are having the 29th annual, and that is next Wednesday. We are still looking for volunteers. So if anybody has any opportunity, all of our folks are just so short-staffed, and we're used to having so many folks be able to come out. So if you can give any time to that, we would welcome it. Concerts will continue. Man, the last concert was, I think, huge. It was amazing. And I think the 80s Nation will be just wonderful as well as we're starting to close on the summer season. Just a mention of the Lantern Festival coming up. I know that everybody's excited about that. Another really big save the date, the Candidates Forum. It'll be countywide. That is on Tuesday, October 4th, and it's at RCC, and we'll be in the ADT Auditorium again. We are partnering with the other two chambers to do that. It will be the same format with questions that are asked by the chambers as a group, but then also they will allow audience questions that will be pulled together and asked towards the end. We get a lot of questions about that, so just wanted to put that out there. You do have a list of new members also. As I mentioned, we have a lot. Representative Reese Pirtle, as you mentioned earlier, he joined the chamber, and then Kim Dow Permanent Makeup, which we talked about. Carroll Creek Golf Club, if you have not had the opportunity, they are the new owners of what was formerly known as the Plantation Golf Club. They are working on the front nine and expecting that to be up and running and then be able to use the funds and the things that are necessary from that being open to open up the full 18. So it would be really, I think, great. The folks who live over there are really excited about it. And I know that it's not inside the city limits, but I think that it's very important that we, golf is just a big thing here. So I think we continue to make that better. Genesis Ministries of Rockingham County, I'm sure you're all familiar with Genesis and the work that they do there. It's very important. It goes along with a lot of the other things that we're putting time and effort into. Sandy Cross General Merchandise, again, not in the city limits, but they are members of the chamber, and the owners are Ira and Amy Tilly, who also have the car wash and the cooler ice, but also in partnership with their brother and sister-in-law, Edward and Amy Smith. So Abner Bullens, who's also running for an office, Carlson Engineering, Wilson Appliances, which is one of my favorite. I know a lot of y'all probably know Shantez Wilson. I have known him since we were on Settle Street, and he was coming in at one point weekly and was meeting with when Sean Gorman was out at the county and helping businesses. And he told me when he retired, he said, if anybody that I have met with will make it, it will be him, and not just for his sense of entrepreneurship, but for his dedication and his persistence. And sure enough, here we are. He's had Wilson Appliances for a couple of years now, and they've joined the chamber, and we're going to do a ribbon cutting, and we're real excited about that. And then also Kelly Stanfield Carter has joined, and she's also running for office. The September coffee will be hosted by the United Way, but it will be at the YMCA. So we will be there for September, and don't let that sneak up on you because it's on the 1st. So it's Thursday, September 1st at 9 a.m. Also, I just wanted to introduce officially, I know most of you by now have met, but some of you may have not. So our administrative assistant, if you stand, please. This is Bambi Tolbert, and she is, not only has she been a wonderful asset, some of you may recognize her if you've ever had animals that you took to Wentworth Animal, or she also worked at a car dealership when it was hometown. And so she's been involved with things with us throughout the year. So we're really excited to have her and welcome her. And she may also come sometimes in my place. So thank you. Any questions? Okay.
Thank you so much.
Thank you, Diane.
Councilwoman Walker.
Thank you, Mayor. Speaking of chamber, mayor and city manager and police department. Y'all have kept me busier this month than I have been for 2.5 years. And due to the length of time, I'm going to turn my report in to the clerk. But I do, since I have the floor, okay, Mr. Festerman, since I have the floor, I will talk about another issue. During our active training session, I had the honor of meeting Cheryl Walker, no relation. She has been at our wastewater treatment plant, for many years. In fact, before the city took it over, it was my understanding that she was working for that company then. During the hard times of COVID, she worked third shift, and she would work 7 days straight, because they couldn't get enough workers to come in. And then she would start the next week. So to me, she is one of the many unsung heroes that work for the city of Reidsville. And by the way, no relation, but it's Cheryl Walker. And if you see her or know her, just give her a pat on the back, because that's what kind of people we have working for the city of Reidsville. Thank you, Mayor.
Councilman Harrison.
Oh, thank you, Mayor. July the 19th, I attended the NAACP Zoom, and July 22nd, attended the new school superintendent's over for that greeting. Attended the active shooter training, and also attended the August 2nd National Night Out, which was at First Baptist Church, and had a great time there. And also Ann Rustin, they always have wonderful homemade ice cream. And then Wentworth Baptist Church had a great, great turnout there. Hot dogs, hamburgers. It was just a really nice time, and just talking to all of the citizens, neighbors, and I think it was just a great time for all. And the turnout from the police department, fire department, as well, was just a great thing. Great connection citizens have with our city of Reidsville. That's my report.
Councilwoman Scoville.
Thank you, Mayor. July 14th, the Kiwanis Club. July 15th, I attended the opioid roundtable at R-Care, which was a wonderful event. Also on the 15th, visitation for Mike Farkas for his funeral. The 18th, we had a meeting with the mayor. The 21st, Kiwanis Club again. Also the 21st, we met with Lisa and John Sean Stover, superintendent of schools. That was a wonderful night. The 25th, active shooter seminar at the Regional Police Department. The 28th, I attended the funeral for Robin Yount's mother. On the 28th, also the Kiwanis Club. The 28th, also had a closed council meeting. Busy day. August 1st, I met with some Reidsville constituents about several different problems that they were concerned about. Also on August 1st, the active shooter meeting in the chambers that was a drill. August 2nd, RDC board meeting, where they discussed the FAD festival coming up in October, and also approved a facade grant for Amos Welding Roof. Also on the 2nd, Reidsville Primary Care ribbon cutting. Also on the 2nd was National Night Out, where we had visited 3 different locations with Sergeant Carter. On the 4th, the Chamber Coffee, hosted by the Greensboro Swarm. August 4th, the Kiwanis Club. August 5th, Wright Chapel Memorial Ribbon Cutting at Annie Penn Hospital. And today I went to Landings of Rockingham County Open House behind Rose Foods. Amazing, wonderful facility. And it's for the aged, and also for if you need care. But it's absolutely wonderful. 3 meals a day, housekeeping, everything provided. It's beautiful. If you have a chance, go by and visit them. And also, I nominated Amy from Reidsville Trading Post as our Main Street Champion to the RDC. That was my mark.
Councilman Festerman.
Thank you, Mayor. I'd like to compliment the folks responsible for the last concert at the park downtown. I think I've been to most of them, and I think this was the best attended, well organized and man well. That concludes my remark.
Okay, I've got 21 different places that I visited, and rather than read all 21 of those, I'll just say this. It's a joy working for the citizens of Reidsville, and we as a council do our very best to make Reidsville one of the best places ever to live and to grow. And that concludes my report. I'd like to also, if you don't believe I got 21 here, I'd like to also name Ashton McLaurin to the Reidsville Housing Authority. I'm granted that opportunity as mayor to do so. If there be no further business,